Hello, hello. This is Christina Werner. Welcome to another live stream here at my YouTube channel. And we're going to jump right into today's projects. I'm going to be creating two different cards using two stamp sets. I've already picked them out. My idea for the cards for for tonight's live stream is to take a really large shape, whether a circle or a heart, and we're going to put it on the front of the card, just as a guide. And then we're going to take little tiny stamps and fill in that shape with colorful stamping. I was trying to think of a way to use very small stamps, and I thought this would be perfect. So welcome. Hello, everyone in the chat. I'm so glad you're here. Oh, some of you are talking about class. You just finished day three. So excited. Yeah, let me know. I'd love some live feedback in the chat for how you're liking class. Love it. So many people from all over the place. Kentucky, Southern California, Connecticut, Ontario, Canada. So many of you, thank you for joining me tonight. So the two stamp sets I'm using are both 6x8 stamp sets. The first one is the Autumn Wreath Builder from Gina K. And this is a particularly nice set for this particular technique that I'm going to show you, because all of the stamps, with the exception of the circle here and the greetings, all of them are small. So it's perfect for, you know, filling in gaps, like on a shape. The other stamp set is Mix and Match Circles from Simon Says Stamp. And we're going to be using just a couple of the images here. I'm thinking we'll either use the little hearts or we'll use the stars. So, love it. Okay, I've got a bunch of acrylic blocks over here. I'm going to do all hand stamping, except for maybe when I add a greeting later. But for the initial stamping, it'll all be by hand with no additional tools. Have a bit of grid paper here in case I need to stamp off a little bit. And the inks I'm using today are from Concord and Ninth. And I like, you know, when I'm switching colors a lot, I like to just use this set of ink cubes because they're so cute and tiny and you have a bunch of colors all together. All right, so let's get going here. I'm gonna start with the little stars and hearts. In fact, maybe I should get, you know, do them together. The first thing I'm going to do is this card base. It's going to be a one layer card. So the first thing I'm going to do is just kind of tape it closed because I don't want to have to deal with it flapping up and down. I'm using blue painter's tape for that. I'm taking some of the stickiness away by putting it on the back of my hand and then peeling it off. Just the oils on my hand make it a little bit less sticky. And then I've just doubled it over into a little circle and then press that down. All right. Oh, someone's saying aloha, Noreen. Okay, you guys. I don't remember if I said where we were going on a trip soon, but we were going to go to Hawaii in 2 weeks, and we just canceled our trip today because of COVID. I'm really bummed. So when someone said aloha, it just made me think of Hawaii. You know, someday I will make my way to Hawaii. It will happen. Just not in 2 weeks. I'm really sad. And bummed. Anyway. Okay, so for the shape on this one, I think we're going to do a heart. So I'm going to use, let's see if I have the die set here, the Nested Hearts die set from Simon. And I'm not really going to cut anything with it. I'm just using the heart as a guide, right? I'm just going to place it on my card so that, yeah. Oh, someone in the comments says my therapist just got back from Hawaii and got COVID. Okay, this is a sign. This is telling me that it was a good decision. Because I've been doubting all day, like maybe we should have gone, maybe we should try to go. But that just tells me, yes, I should, yeah. Yeah. Oh, is Debbie calling me Jennifer? She's like, oh, sorry, it's not the time. You're right to cancel. Well, this is Christina. Or maybe you're talking to someone in the chat. I'm not entirely sure. Sue, Hawaii has not put any restrictions in place, but the governor has asked visitors to not come through the end of October at the soonest. So, yeah. Anyway, it's a bummer because, I mean, my husband and I have only, like, planned two kind of larger trips. The first one was when we were supposed to get married in San Diego, and that one was canceled 2 days before we had to go. Thankfully, this one's canceled 2 weeks before. I have a little more time. Yeah, anyway. So I'm not going to die cut this, but I am going to use a little bit of this Easy C tape to hold the die in place. Actually, I'm trying to decide, do I want to pencil it in or do I want to just, you know, I don't want to deal with erasing pencil later. We'll just do this. We're not going to be stamping that close to the edge that we have to worry about the, you know, the die getting in the way. All right. So this is the stamp set we're using, Mix and Match Circles from Simon's Stamp. And let's get going here. Okay, so I think, let's see, hearts or stars? I think I'm gonna do hearts. Like, it's gonna be like a big heart made out of hearts. Okay, so I've got some acrylic blocks here. I've only got a few little hearts here. This is a, kind of like a medium and a tiny one. Yeah, I don't have any other ones. I just have these two sizes. So it's not gonna take much, like, going between, but I do want to pick out a few different colors. Okay, so this is kind of lovey, so maybe we'll do like pinks. So honeysuckle, ballet slippers, let's put a little bit of yellow in there, and aqua sky. No, not aqua sky, we're gonna do sea glass. Oh, those colors are so cute. And I think I will add dove down here at the bottom. All right, let's zoom in here so you guys can see a little bit better what I'm doing. Oh, my nails, they are red today. I had the French manicure. It was a gel polish manicure, and I wanted to try to get a little more wear out of it, so I painted my nails with regular polish. Just put it right on top. All right, so we're gonna do a bunch of ink switching today. Let's see. I'm gonna set this up for my best results possible. I'm just making myself a little line of ink pads so I can swap between colors easier. Also have my little stamp chamois from L'Enfant so I can clean off my stamps. And I have my two little heart stamps going right here. All right, I think I'm gonna start on one side and then go to the other. So we'll start with a little bit of, oh, this is gonna get messy, a little bit of ballet slippers. Oh, that is such a pale little thing. You can't even see it. There you go. Well, I can see it. All right, switch to a smaller stamp. We'll do honeysuckle right next to it. Clean that off. Come into buttercup. And I'm kind of turning the stamp as well. You know, I'm gonna take my stamp chamois. I'm gonna place, I don't know if you guys will be able to see it, but I'm gonna place it on my work surface and then I can just rub the stamp against it. So it's laying on my work surface and then just rub the stamp. Okay. Let's see, gotta be another heart. Let's do that in dove. We'll come in right here. Oh, that's such a pretty gray. And then we'll come into sea glass and we'll put one right there. So pretty. This is actually going a lot faster than I thought it would. All right, into honeysuckle again. And then we'll come to ballet slippers and come down here in this corner. So basically I'm just trying to stamp everything going across. Easy enough. Okay. Need a big stamp. We'll do that one in Honeysuckle. Those of you who are in crocheting on cardstock right now, in my day one, I think it was my day one video, I couldn't remember the color of cardstock that I was using. It was Honeysuckle. And I was just hearing in my head Greg from Concord and Ninth screaming, "It's Honeysuckle!" All right, we need a big heart, and we're going to do it in yellow. And Buttercup, we'll put it right up here. It's going to be tricky as I come right into this section to get everything spaced out just right, but I think we'll be okay. You know what? I'm going to do another big heart. We'll do in Honeysuckle. And I'll just fill in that little curve up there at the top. And coming into Dove. And Sea Glass. All right, and then I'm going to do another Buttercup heart right there. So it's just filling in all those gaps. Let's see. So I'm assessing the situation right here, like what color do I think needs to go right here? We only have ballet slippers in a couple spots. I think that might be a good time to do another big heart for ballet slippers. Also, in another random development, that those of you who are watching the edited replay, you won't hear this discussion, so you're missing out. So if you ever, they won't even know I'm talking about them because they're not watching it, but I got this Apple Watch band back in June, and I've worn it almost exclusively. I haven't swapped it out to anything else. And it was starting to look so gray and just gross, and I could just tell it wasn't clean. But I still wanted to keep wearing it. So I looked it up online, and some guy, he recommended, just like soak it in some warm water, put a little detergent in there, and you know, you'll be fine. So I did that, and I couldn't see that it was really changing and cleaning enough. So what I did, okay. So you guys might have seen that, like, I use like a nail brush to clean off my stencils. Like, I have two nail brushes at my sink. One's for crafting, for cleaning off stencils, and the other is to actually clean under my nails. So I had the brush there. I'm like, I wonder. And I took the brush, and I had the soapy water. It had a little bit of Tide in it, and it was like lukewarm. And then I took the nail brush, and I like scrubbed my watch band. Crazy! So much gunk came out of it, and then it dried beautifully. It's so nice and vibrant again. I love it. So there's my little tip. For those of you who have gotten these like braided watch bands, whether it's, you know, Apple brand or not, because I know there's a lot of like other companies doing them too, like go ahead and try washing it. It turned out great. Oh, this is going to be so cute. Look at that. So adorable. Oh, Marilyn, you got a booster vaccine shot today. Awesome. I'm excited to get my booster shot. I probably won't be able to get it for a while, unfortunately, because I got the Johnson & Johnson, but they did just announce today, Johnson & Johnson did, that there is a 9-fold increase in antibodies after you get a booster. I'm like, sweet. So I will for sure be doing that as soon as I can. And if they go by the same like booster schedule as what is being suggested right now, it'll be 8 months after my original shot. So that would be November. All right, I'm gonna peel this up a little bit and move it so I can get that edge. Okay, I'm looking like I need ballet slippers right here. I'm gonna switch to a big heart. And we'll just fill that gap right there. I'm also very hopeful with the Pfizer vaccine being approved for use, like not conditional or emergency use. It is the full thing. I'm excited about that because I'm hoping those who have been concerned about that, I hope it will, you know, assuage some of your fears. I think it's a good thing. All right, I'm gonna go to a big heart. See, it's getting more and more complicated as I get up into this corner. I'm like, how am I going to fit that in there? 42 Rosie is saying, okay, but what are the stats for if you've already had COVID? Do we still need a booster? I would say that I am not your medical doctor. You could ask your medical doctor. With that being said, I would say yes. The way I've had it described to me is if you have had COVID and recovered, and you have the vaccine, you have stellar antibodies. They're gonna fight that off. So, you know, take all the advantages you can. Having a booster if you've had COVID is not going to harm you any more than, you know, if you hadn't had COVID. So, yes, booster helps. In fact, I know people who have had COVID and they have not, you know, they've chosen not to get the vaccine because they're like, well, I recovered from it once. Like, why do I need to? You know, to each their own. But if I had had COVID, granted, this is me who had the vaccine anyway. But if I had had COVID, I would get the vaccine anyway because you don't know how you're going to react to it every time, you know? Like, I just talked with someone earlier tonight who she had COVID back in January. And, sorry, I'm trying to think what color I need next. Ballet slippers. And she didn't have very many symptoms. She just had a loss of smell and that was it. So she was good. But then she was just diagnosed today. She got her positive test result today. So she has it again and got it from her back to school night. She went to back to school night for her kids and that's where she got it. Anyway, and let's see, I got to fill in this gap right here. Honeysuckle it is. Anyway, she says that this time around, she actually has more symptoms than she had before. She says it's mostly like a really bad cold, but, it really, you know, that's surprising that someone who had it before and had practically no symptoms at all is, you know, reacting differently. So she probably had the original COVID and now she has, you know, like the Delta variant, probably. Okay. And sorry to bring up like all this stuff. I know a lot of you probably just want to like, you know, see the crafting and whatever. I get it. Hopefully those who have not wanted to, talk or think about it, they'll be watching the edited replay. And if you're not cool with what we're talking about right now, no problem. X out, come back for the edited replay because I'll speed over all this when I edit. I just have a lot of stamping to do, so I gotta talk through it all. Okay, let's see what color ballet slippers. This is getting harder and harder. Okay, Honeysuckle. All right, I think I'm just gonna do one more little heart and dove. Oh, there's a little gap right there. You see that? I wish I didn't have that gap. Can't be helped. Okay, so when I remove the die, I'm left with this little heart shape. Isn't that cute? And if you want to emphasize the heart shape even more, you could, you know, like die cut this out of masking paper, put the mask on, and then just a little bit of blending right along the edge. That would totally do it, right? Okay, I love that. That turned out super cute. Okay, so this is a very, playful, kind of almost looks like we're going to the ice cream parlor. That's what it looks like, right? Ice cream parlor. Okay, so let's work on the other card. And for this other one, let me see here, let me put these away. I never put these away in the same exact order, but I try. Okay, I think that was Buttercup, Sea Glass, and Dove. Perfect. Okay, we're gonna come back and do a greeting on this later, but for now, we're gonna leave it. But I do need to put this back in my Nesting Hearts die set before I lose it. Yes, Conversation Heart Candies. That's what I was trying to think of. Thank you. Thank you, Barbara. All right. So now we're going to move on to the Autumn Wreath Builder from Gina K. And I'm going to do a larger card. This is a 5x7 card base that I've already folded and assembled. And I'm going to, I'm thinking I'm going to do a circle, which you could use the actual Wreath Builder to do a circle like this. But we're going to make it a little bit more random because, we're doing it all by hand. So before we move on, I'm going to put my stamps back on my stamp sheet. The bright pink color that I was using is Honeysuckle. I just saw that comment, so I thought I'd answer. Okay, Gina K. Designs Autumn Wreath Builder. And I think I want to use quite a few of these different stamps, so I'm going to use all these blocks. Okay, obviously since this is the Wreath Builder, the Autumn Wreath Builder, I'm planning to do some more autumn colors. So let's see here. What kind of stuff do I want? I think I want this one for sure. And for the little itty bitty block, Let's do this one. I have this weird long block. I guess I could put something on that. We'll do this one. Okay. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we're gonna pick 6 colors. Tissue trick. Try folding up a tissue and putting it under the mask just below the squeeze part that helps catch moisture that would fog the glasses. Oh, interesting. I guess you're talking about wearing masks and glasses. I wear glasses with my masks all the time, and I just find, make sure your mask has a wire on the nose piece, and then just really form it to the nose really well and like push it up so that your glasses can almost rest on top of the mask, like the top nose edge. And then that seems to work well for me. Okay, so 6 colors. We're gonna do cranberry, marmalade, stardust. There, nice. Stardust, parsley. Let's do a little bit of, let's do mushroom. One more. Maybe I will do Buttercup. No, I'm not going to do Buttercup. We're going to do Evergreen. We need like a little bit of a darker green in there. That looks like a really good combination. Okay. Getting all of my blocks lined up here for my stamping. Oh, this is torture. Amy just says, just got in. Aloha from Hawaii. Oh, I want to be in Hawaii so bad. I don't know if it sounds like you just got here. I just announced on here that I had to cancel my trip to Hawaii. That was in 2 weeks. Oh, because of the illness, the sickness that we all hate. The sickness that is not, I mean, it's people's health and people are dying, but it's also a plague on my plants. I'm a planter. It is a plague on all my plants. Okay, I'm going to do like I did before and line up all my blocks. Oh, I apparently have never used evergreen. The sticker's still on it. There we go. Well, time to break it up. I don't think I've stamped, oh, yep, I haven't stamped with mushroom before. Okay. Yes, these colors do scream fall. Okay. So I'm gonna do a circle. So I'm gonna grab my nested circles dies from Simon and pick out a nice circle size. Thinking, nope, that's too small. Go to the next one. Yeah, that's perfect. All right, I'm gonna use those same little strips of EZC tape to kind of hold it in place. So my circle doesn't move around. And then I'm just gonna zoom in a little bit. Okay, sorry, I was reading the comments. All right, I'm gonna start with this cute pumpkin because it's adorable and I'm gonna put him in marmalade. I'll just start right down here. Once again, I'm gonna have my stamp chamois off to the side, and I'm just gonna wipe off each stamp after I use it so that it's clean for the next time. All right, I'm gonna come in with cranberry. Oh, perfect. These inks stamp so well, I'm telling you. Okay, I'm gonna do this little branch in Stardust. And then we'll do this other little leaf in mushroom. Okay. We have another little leaf. We're gonna do that one in parsley. This block is huge compared to the other ones. And then we have another branch. I think I'll come to marmalade. And we'll just fill in this gap right there. All right, I think I've used all the images. But not all the colors. I haven't used evergreen yet. So let's do evergreen in the maple leaf. And we'll do that right here. Oh, that is a pretty color. Looking at the comments, I'm just scrolling up. Dora's asking where I bought my chamois. I got it from Sinus' stamp. Let's see here. Cheryl says, the worst thing about COVID is not being able to plan anything. That is so true. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's continue stamping. I'm going to do another one. Where's that little branch? This one, I think, could be really pretty. In the cranberry color, and we'll just have it come in like, well, it's gonna have to go like this. Perfect. That is a cute little branch. Okay, I need to fill this gap. I think This little leaf would be great. We're going to do him in parsley. Just fill that little gap. Okay, and other random things that I've found that I love. You know, we were talking about how I washed my Apple Watch band earlier. I have discovered, and this is fitting after talking about the Apple Watch band, Apple Fitness Plus. Lisa in the chat here can, well, I think I mentioned it to her that I wanted to do Apple Fitness Plus. Lisa's coming to visit me. She's going to have to try it out with me on Friday when she's here. Right, Lisa? Let's see here. Let's do this one. We'll do that in mushroom. Anyway, Apple Fitness Plus. Love it so much. My friend Leslie, who's local. I've gone on cruises with her in the past. She's tried it and loved it. And I was like, oh, I need to try that out. Oh, seriously, guys, it's so good. Okay, let's see, looking for the other leaf. Let's do, okay, let's do some Stardust. You know, with so many colors, it's almost harder. Okay, what am I doing? We'll do this leaf, and I think I'm gonna do it in the cranberry this time. Just right through there. Gotta figure out this little gap. This little branch kind of has a little bit of a curved line to it, or I could do this one right here. Yeah, let's do this one. I did not clean it off well. Let's clean that off. And I think I want to do that in orange and marmalade. And we'll just put that in right there. Yay, that fills the gap pretty well. What is good about Apple Fitness Plus? Do you need to have an Apple Watch? I need something to track my hikes. Apple Watch is great for tracking hikes. It will track your distance and also your calories. I've done it for hiking before. Apple Fitness Plus is amazing because they have great instructors, a bunch of different like things you can do at home. You don't need a ton of equipment. There is like a strength training aspect, so you will need weights for that. But most of them don't. You don't need any equipment. And all of your stats from your watch, like your heart rate, the time left in the class, like your energy expenditure, like there's a burn bar that like compares how much calories you're burning to other people. All of that is on screen while you're working out. It's great. Okay. I feel like I need another pumpkin. And those just have to be orange, right? So back to marmalade. We'll do a little pumpkin right here. My stamp chamois is getting very dirty. I'm definitely going to have to clean it tonight. Okay, let's see. No, I don't want to do that one. But I could have it come right here. That would look nice. Okay, and we'll do that in evergreen. I've only stamped in evergreen once so far. So this will be perfect. We'll just come in right like, well, oh yeah, that'll be better. Right like that. I don't know why I put the block off to the, or the stamp off to the side of the block. That was weird. Okay. I'm gonna move that. Speaking of, there, now it's in the center. Okay, we need the maple leaf, and let's do that one in mushroom. And we'll just come in right here. I've got this weird gap right here, but maybe I can do one of these, that little branch or something. I think that would work well. Can I do that little branch? Let's test it. I think I can. But I'm gonna have a little gap at the at the end of the circle. That's okay, we'll deal with it. I'm gonna do the branch in cranberry. Oh, that's not bad. That actually fills it in pretty well. Sorry for the squeaking. All right, let's do another one of those leaves. Have we done one of those in a while? I don't think we have. And let's do that in Stardust. And we'll put him right here. Okay, I have just a few things to fill in. I think I want to do this branch again. Not entirely sure how I want to do it though. It would have to be, oh no, it's too close to the other one right here. Let's do this other leaf. Put it in right there, and it is going to be in parsley. All those gaps are getting filled in. Okay, probably one more stamp, and I think it needs to be the maple leaf because that's just so fall to me. Okay, and the color is going to be evergreen. I know we already have an evergreen maple on this, but it's just gonna look so good. Okay, that filled in the gaps pretty well. I'm actually fairly surprised that I was able to get those in so well. All right. Put all the inks away. And pull up that die. That turned out so great. Very fall. Okay. I think Stardust was right there. There we go. Perfect. Okay, so now we need to figure out some greetings for our two little cards. I love that one. It's so cute. So different. Just the different color of inks changes it so much. Let's put these stamps in. All right, now this is like a puzzle trying to figure out where all of the stamps go. My little maple leaf that I love. A little branch that almost looks like coral. Okay. Let's go back into my little storage pocket. Okay, so I'm thinking I'm going to grab some of the Tiny Words stamp sets from Simon, because I want to keep these cards really, really simple. So I thought just like a little greeting, or maybe I'll grab the sentiment strips. The sentiment strips would work really well with this as well. And I'll just cut out some little greetings that I can put on top. So I've got to wander over to my stamp storage and pick that out. All right. I'm thinking the reverse magical wishes might have something for the heart one. Let's see. I'm going through. I have so many of these sentiment strip ones. Welcome spring. Not really going to work for the autumn one. Let's pass that one up. Okay, here's one for a birthday. Halloween. Okay, this one's pretty good. And I think I have like two or three packs of it. The reverse, all things happy. So many kind of just everyday greetings in that one that are awesome. Okay, I think I'll just use that one for both. You can see like how many sheets I have. Okay. Let's see here. I think like a sending happy thoughts could be good on that one. And wishing all you all that is happy. Okay. We're gonna cut out some of these greetings now. Where is my X-Acto knife? Here we go. And a little ruler. Just gonna use a little 6-inch ruler from Lanfan. And cut this out. I like to use a ruler and a craft knife to cut these out because then you can cut the greeting out of just the center and you still can leave the rest of the sheet intact. There we go. Wishing you all that is happy. And then, let's see. I think I'm doing the one right above it that says, I am so happy you are my friend. That's a cute greeting. Okay. I've never used one of these sentiment strip packs all the way through, but if I did, it would be this one. Reverse all things happy. Seriously, I use it all the time. Okay. I think I'm going to end up cutting these down into multiple strips. So, I am so happy you are my friend. And just put that right over there. And then for this one, wishing you all that is happy. Perfect. I love that. I'm gonna use some really thin Darice foam strips. So these cards are really simple, although you saw how time consuming, right? But I hope it gives you guys some ideas on what you can do with very small images in stamp sets. I think the small images get overlooked quite a bit. Alrighty, put some more foam on the back of these. So the last few days I have been making 5 million cards in anticipation of going to Hawaii for 2 weeks, which is not happening. So I guess I'll just get an early jump start on my holiday card series. How about that? It doesn't start till end of October. Okay. I just have to laugh at this point. What's that saying about God laughs when you make plans or something like that? It's probably true. or rather COVID laughs. Okay, so when I do little greetings like this, I like to have them just a little bit off, not perfectly straight, because it makes me think of that magnetic poetry. Did you guys ever do that? We had a magnetic poetry set in one of my apartments in college. It was lots of fun. Okay, so I like them just a little off. So here we go. I am so happy. I'm gonna keep telling myself that. I am so happy that you are my friend, which that's true. Okay, I think this one is calling out to me for some dash lines. I'm trying to decide where I will put them. Do I put them just around the outside edge? What do? I think I'm gonna do them just around the outside edge. But I don't want them like right up against the edge. I want them a little bit away from the edge. So they're about half an inch, maybe a little more than half an inch. Well, yeah, about a half an inch away from the edge. And as I'm drawing my dash line, I'm like thinking, okay, you know, I'm constantly checking myself to make sure I'm the right distance away from the edge. I think for such a large card, it needed to have a little border to help kind of just bring in the design and image area of the card. There was just a lot of negative unused space going on. Okay, yeah, I think it needed that. Just that little pop of white, totally needed that. Okay. So here are the two cards for today. I love how these turned out, and I did them in less than an hour. Worked out great. All right, so I'm gonna do my little ending voiceover for those that are watching the edited version, and then we'll get into answering some questions here at the after party, after show, whatever we're calling it. So here are the two cards for today's live stream. I hope you guys enjoyed and that gave you some ideas on what to do with those smaller images in your stamp sets, or even stamp sets that are made up of all small images. This is something that you can do. So thank you so much for watching today and tuning in. I will be back very soon with more card videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. All right, here we are, after show. So if you guys have any questions, let me know. I'm scrolling up to catch things. Okay, let's see here. You guys are talking about something. What is it? Something about a knife? Like a craft knife, maybe? I'm trying to catch on to what you guys were talking about. Let's see here. Liz said something, I watch her with it and I wonder about the finger knife. What? Okay, let's see. Have you seen the finger knife? I just got one. I can control it much better than a craft knife. I'm craft knife challenge. That's what Mary said. Talking about the Fiskars orange one that kind of wraps around your finger and then you can like use your finger to cut. You know, I used to have one. It was okay, but I'm just so used to using a craft knife, you know, to each their own. Whatever's going to be best for you. Let's see. Kathy asked Christina regarding upcoming Christmas cards. Can you do some completely new and some old card redos? That would be fun to see. So I think it was my last video, was it? I think it was. I asked for your opinion on doing reaction cards, and I didn't, I should have clarified. I've only been doing the reaction videos on Fridays. So if I was going to do it during the holiday card series, it would only be on Fridays, which would mean it would be every third card. So it wasn't that I was going to do the whole series as a reaction to old cards. It was going to be a mix from the start. But I think it's a kind of a fun idea. I think I might do it. I don't know if I'll keep it to the Friday schedule, but I think it'd be fun. Let's see here. I'm not sure exactly what you're referring to. Were the cards for Christmas or holidays or for those in Hawaii? That's very nice of you to do. I think you're referring to my comment about working ahead. And it wasn't because I was taking the cards to Hawaii or anything. It was because I wanted everything pre-filmed for while I was gone so that I could share those videos while I was gone. So that's what that meant. But because I'll be a little bit ahead now, I can either just slow down and take my time, or I could just keep moving ahead and I'll catch up to my holiday card series stuff. So that's what I meant by that. Let's see here. Scrolling down. Seeing more of your comments. Scrolling. Oh, thank you. All of you guys saying the cards are good. Chris is asking, what happened to the Hawaii trip? COVID happened to the Hawaii trip. The governor of Hawaii has asked visitors not to come. And it isn't like a requirement, but I mean, he was saying like, you know, don't come to Hawaii right now. It's not going to be the trip that you planned, which I totally get. Yeah, it's not going to be like what we had wanted. So we'll just go another time. Oh, Jen's watching and playing Animal Crossing. Good job. I have not played Animal Crossing in weeks. I'm sure all of my villagers want to leave my island by now. Are reverse sentiments laser ink? Is that what you mean? So you could foil? Yes, they are laser printed. So you can foil them. I haven't done it, but I really want to. It looks fun. Mary says, I hope you will get to Hawaii soon. Me too. Oh, I really want to go to Hawaii. Is there a particular product coming out in September that you're excited about? A stamp set, one that I designed. It is so dang cute. I'm so excited for it to come out. There are a couple really cute ones, actually. I'm you know, like I said, I'm filming ahead. And so I'm going to use this particular stamp set that I'm really excited about. I think I'm going to be using it on... It would be, when would it be? Later in the month, probably like near mid-month. Sorry, I was looking at my list of cards I had planned. It'd probably be mid-month. I wanted to ask, aside from card making, do you also happen to do journaling? You know what, I don't. I probably should, but I do not. I feel like this card is getting blown out. Because it's like so bright. Tip that up. There we go. Okay. How do you stop stays on ink from sticking when you stamp? I don't know that there's a way to prevent that because the ink just is so sticky, and it's formulated that way specifically because you can use it on slick surfaces. So it has to have that like stickiness that grabs the slick surface. So I don't know that you can really avoid it. I would say if you're having trouble, like it pulls on this block or whatever, maybe use your Misty. I think, you know, use like a stamp positioning tool because that will give you a better chance of precision, but I'm not sure there's any way you can stop it completely. Was Hawaii for vacay or work related? It was completely a vacation. Yeah, and then we have other travel planned for the fall and into winter, and I'm like, this does not bode well. Yeah, I'm kind of bummed right now, but you know what though? I will get back into it, you know? When I look back at like spring of 2020, when like everything shut down, a lot of bad and negative things happened, but at the same time, I look back on that time really fondly because I didn't have the distraction of travel or whatever, and I had been traveling, you know, like once a month or, you know, multiple times over a couple months, and it was like for a long, long time, because everything came to a standstill, I was so productive. I got into a really good routine. There was this kind of like life coach guy that was doing like every single day they would get on at the same time, and it was just like a 1 hour of productivity, and you could do whatever you need to get done. And I was so productive. That was when I was sending a ton of cards. I used that hour a day to just address cards and do envelopes and mail them. And then I was trying to get out of the house. And so I would walk them to the mailbox in my neighborhood. And that was just like a really, like I have some good memories about that time. That was also when I had mono. So I was like super low energy and just couldn't do a whole lot. And it really forced me to slow down. So I don't know. I have some fond memories of that. I think it's different now. I'm in a little bit of a different place. Like we have the new house. We're setting things up. Granted, if I was not traveling at all and not doing anything like that, that would free up a lot of time to work on projects around the house that I need to do anyway. So, you know, I'll talk myself back into it, but right now, kind of bummed that there's no Hawaii in my future, in the near future anyway. Let's see here. Sandy says, I get so many ideas in my head. How do you rein it in and focus on one idea? It sounds like you need a card sketchbook. Sketch out your cards, get those ideas down. And like, if you have specific products you want to use for those ideas, maybe note them off to the side and then move on. And then when you have time to actually make them, then you can go back and look at your ideas and decide which one you want to do. And then when maybe, you know, you'll have a lull in your creativity, you can go back to those ideas that you had never done, that you never had a chance to do, and you can do them. Okay. Chrissy's asking, what do you mean reaction cards? On my YouTube channel over the last little while on Fridays, I've had a reaction video, meaning I'm watching an older card video of my own, I'm reacting to that video, and then I recreate the card using current product. So I'm, in a way, using myself as inspiration. yeah. Okay, here. Scrolling down. What are your thoughts on having very focused stamps for everything occasion versus more general stamps? Do you mean like having a specific get well stamp and then having a specific birthday stamp? Is that what you mean? Or are you talking about like you have one stamp set and it covers like a bunch of stuff? I say bring it on, whatever it is, I'm all for it. But I do like general stamps in that Outside of birthday cards and maybe the occasional sympathy card, I really just send like really more generic like friendship cards, you know, like miss you or, you know, thinking of you. Like nothing's really super specific. Every once in a while there will be something more specific, but okay. Christina, have you had issues with some cardstock when you spray water? It bubbles up. Yes, if you add water to regular cardstock, it can warp the cardstock, or sometimes it'll get like raised little like bubble areas. It's not really bubbles. It's like where water droplets have hit the paper, and then the paper softens and it creates like a texture spot. In order to prevent that, you know, like the only time I really spritz or spray water on my cards is when I'm going to be using an embossing folder. And so what I do for that is I spray in the air and I can kind of like wave my card through it and you get a finer mist, and that helps quite a bit. Christy asks, when does the holiday card series start? It starts at the end of October. Oh yeah, Jean, you canceled a trip to Hawaii too? Ugh. Did you reschedule? Did you go again? Let's see. Oh, Yvette made a card as I did. Awesome. Such a good idea. Oh, Lauren, I logged on to Animal Crossing today and two villagers asked to leave. Isn't that just how it goes? Let's see. Someone asked if Concord and Neenah are water reactive or waterproof. They are not water reactive, but I believe they are waterproof once dry. Does it say anything about them on them? It doesn't say on the packaging, but I think at their website it might say that. You know what? This is a good question for all of you. How do you guys clean your chamois? I was thinking of just taking it over to the sink, using a little bit of hand soap and kind of frothing it up. You designed a stamp set for Stamptember. I have quite a few stamp sets and dies in Stamptember. It is by far the biggest release that Simon puts out over the entire year. It is massive. It's huge. Be prepared, save your monies. It's a lot, it's big. It's a really big release. And that's not even taking into account all the special collaboration sets with other companies, which are awesome this year as well, which they come out, you know, mostly daily throughout the month. Sometimes there's a day or two skipped or whatever, but mostly daily. But those are not announced or revealed until the day they're available. And they're only available until they run out of stock. So, and they don't restock them. So if you want them, you have to get them. Let's see. Oh no, you're in lockdown in Sydney, Australia. Oh, well, I'm glad you're able to, you know, hop online and watch some live streams and some crafting. Let's see. So did we, and we have a rescheduled trip in December. If we don't go by the end of the year, we lose quite a bit of our deposits and airfare. Oh, crap. I'm sorry. We're in the same boat. Not end of the year, but we had an Airbnb booked, and we could only get half of our, like, payment back or, like, rebook it for next spring. So I think we're going to rebook it for next spring and, like, cross our fingers and hope that maybe it's a little bit like this year was, where this spring into summer, things kind of calm down. I'm really hoping. We'll see. Let's see here. Jackie asks, do you know if there will be Halloween stamps during Stamptember? I don't know if I can confirm or deny that there are Halloween stamps, but I will tell you this. In the past, Simon has included Halloween, some Thanksgiving, and also Christmas products in the Stamptember release. That's all I can say. Okay. Oh, yeah. I do deserve a vacation. Can we plan a staycation? I should plan a Hawaiian themed live stream around the time I was supposed to be in Hawaii and do all tropical cards. Or would that just make my heart hurt? It might make my heart hurt. What is your favorite Disney character? Ariel, by far. She was my princess growing up. The movie was released in 1989, I believe. I was 7 years old, or maybe it was 87. No, I think it was 89. And I was 7 years old. And The Little Mermaid, as far as like Disney history goes, it really ushered in the renaissance of Disney animation. Can you believe that at some point, like in the early 80s, the Disney company was considering shutting down animation completely? Like they had like flop after flop after flop, and it was just a big money pit. They were losing money. And then here comes this little movie about a mermaid. Dang. So glad that happened. And then it was just like hit after hit after hit. It was like Little Mermaid, and then it was Beauty and the Beast, and then Lion King, and Aladdin, and all those movies all came in just one after the other. And it ushered in this renaissance of Disney animation that is just phenomenal. And it was like the perfect storm of talented people and artists and actors and musicians and technicians, everyone coming together to create these amazing movies. Now, you look back at the movies now, and some of them can technically be a little bit problematic considering the themes in the movie or just how some of the storyline goes. But at the time, it was just enchanting. That's the word that I would put for it. And Ariel was my princess because it was like, let's see, how old would I have been? I would have been 7. I was either 5 or 7. I'm pretty sure it was 89. So I would have been 7 years old when it came out. I remember going to the theater to see it with my friends for my birthday. Yeah. Yeah. I love Ariel. I have a piece done by Karen Aruda, a paper piecing of Ariel and Flounder and Sebastian. I've got to find a place to put it in my craft room. I haven't hung it up yet. Maybe I'll do that this weekend, find a place for it. Oh, Amanda answered, I think it's The Little Mermaid. She knew right away. let's see. I know what you mean, fondness at that time. We tried new recipes and whatnot. It was fun to have my hubs all to myself. Yes, I tried this like artisan bread recipe. I was trying chocolate chip cookie recipes from bakeries in the United Kingdom. And like during like spring of 2020, I did so many fun things that I normally wouldn't have time for. Yeah. Okay, here we go. Sorry, I'm really slow catching up with these comments. Let's see here. Are the Concord and Ninth inks, do they come as a complete set like you have? Yes, you can purchase them as a complete set. I don't know if they're in stock as a complete set, but I do know that they carry it as a complete set. Oh, yay, Liz. Just wanted to say I'm loving the cardstock class. I'm so happy you are. We've loved putting that together. I had so much fun with my cards. Oh, Jean, you haven't rescheduled. I know, it's hard. We don't know what days to pick yet. Crazy. Oh, Lisa's answering about the stamp chamois, sink and soap. All right. So my thought was good. Does it take a long time for pigment ink to dry? Like Gina K's amalgam. Generally, yes, pigment inks take a little bit longer to dry. I have found that with Gina K's amalgam ink, it is not as time consuming for it to dry as some other types of pigment ink have been in the past. I think it dries a little bit more quickly, but in general, yes, pigment inks do take longer to dry. Gina washes her chamois in the washing machine? Like with what? Like with towels or something? Oh, sink with some baby shampoo. That's a good one. Dawn dish soap spray. Nice. Do you like Pink Fresh Inks or Concord a Ninth better? Unfortunately, I can't give a comparison on that because I don't think I have any Pink Fresh Inks. So, sorry, can't help that one. Hot water and wringing out the chamois cleans pretty well. Good to know. Let's see. Let's see. I think I'm almost caught up. Let's see. Sorry, I'm just reading through things. KC says, I'm new to stamping. Are these releases like seeing the first showing of a movie at midnight? How do they work? Well, I can't speak for other companies, but I know for Simisa Stamp, when they have a release for their brand, it's at midnight Eastern. That's when it is revealed on the website and you can see it. The same thing happens for the company collaborations during Stamp Timber. You see them at midnight Eastern. That being said, sometimes Simon does send out newsletters a few hours in advance and you can get a sneak peek of what that release is. I don't know if they do that for the company collaboration sets, but I do know they do that for the Simon releases. And so you can see the release a little bit before it's completely shown to the public. So go sign up for their newsletter if you want to get that and you'll get a little sneak peek. Let's see. What's a super smooth cardstock? Almost like photo paper. Well, it's not photo paper and it's not glossy, but I find that the Concord and Ninth white cardstock, it's not as thick, but it's super, super smooth. But I find that the Neenah Classic Crest Solar White is really, really smooth also. It's great for blending. So I don't look for a different smooth cardstock. Let's see here. Oh, that's so fun. You directed Little Mermaid musical. Love that. What calligraphy pens do you recommend? Any brush tip marker is awesome. I really like the Karen Brush Marker Pros. They can have a little bit of a steep entry point though, so you might try Tombow Dual pens. Those are really good too. I also like the Marvy Le Pen Flex. Those are really great. They're pretty small though. So if you're just starting out, it might be hard to get control of those. Okay, let's see here. Almost caught up. Oh, okay, I am caught up. Yay. I think someone was asking about, let's see. Do you ever use an electronic cutting machine like a Silhouette? Not anymore. In fact, I gave away my Silhouette when I moved because it was just collecting dust. I hadn't used it in so long. So no, not anymore. Looking for a really good quality, affordable watercolor set. I would recommend the Sakura Koi Pocket Filled Sketchbox 24 set. That is a really good one. Yeah, that's probably the one I would recommend. I also like the Gansai Tambi, the Kuretake Zig Gansai Tambi palettes, but their paints are a little bit on the opaque side. They're not quite as transparent, but they're really great. They don't come with a mixing palette. They come in a box and you can't really mix on the paper box. So you have to have a separate palette to mix colors. So I don't recommend that one right away. I'd really go with the Sakura Koi watercolors. Let's see here. Let's see. All right. So those are all the questions that I can see right now in the chat. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm going to close this up so I can go edit the replay and get it up as fast as I can. Yeah. So thank you for joining. Hey, Kitty. I can hear, I think it's Sophie meowing. Sophie. She's at the bottom of the stairs. She's just like, meow, 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 meow. Anyway, thank you guys so much for joining me today. I will be back on Monday. And thank you for watching. I will see you guys very soon.